Northwest Monster Truck Facebook page here. We have Al Payne, the owner of Straight Up Racing, and just want to ask about what's new in his racing team.
Well, as you said, you know, we're back here at the SU Art Shop. Every week, you know, that we have spare time, we try to build something. It's everything. If anybody has kind of watched us over the past few years, we're constantly trying to expand, change, grow, you know, whether we're creating. So, you know, one thing that since we joined forces with the Malicious Monster Truck Tour, one of the things we want to be able to bring is we've had this extra ride truck sitting just at the shop doing nothing for the last, you know, year. So we thought, let's just start bringing it with us. So we got an extra trailer. We're just going to bring the ride truck, but I didn't want to have the Dodge ride truck trying to, you know, be sitting there with nobody wanting to ride it because we got the new dog truck, because that thing has been, you know, a huge success. Everybody wants to ride the DOG ride truck. So that's what we thought. Since we've already changed the truck, you know, Skeletor is not being run this year, we're going to go ahead and change the ride truck around, and we're putting the Skeletor body on this ride truck frame. So it's, if you see outside, the old Dodge body, which is a steel body truck, it's sitting outside. And then, so we got the body off, and then I kept looking at the 318, you know, Dodge motor with the fuel injection and the wiring harness and all the stuff that really is kind of like speaking, you know, gibberish to me, because I'm not a fuel injection computerized kind of guy. So it's I just thought, you know, while we're doing all this work, we might as well go ahead and put a big block Chevrolet in it. So we lowered the motor down, so its drive lines will have better angles. So pretty much we started over again. I mean, the only thing we're using is the rear ends and the main frame. Everything else will be built new. So you see the body starting to get the roll cage in it, and then we'll start getting the seat structure and all that built. Hopefully I'll be done by the time we leave for the Redmond show. Again, it's time is probably our worst enemy. You know, there's never enough time to be able to do all the shows, to be able to spend time with families, and then be able to create and build stuff. You know, creations is probably the thing I love the most. It's just be able to, you know, look at something and try to, you know, vision and then create it. It gives a great satisfaction when you, you know, sit back and have your coffee in the morning and look at what you've accomplished the day before. The beginning of a project is usually probably the most satisfying part, because everything goes so fast. You go from just a pile of tubing to, you know, it grows very fastly on creating stuff, and you see your work progress so fast versus towards the end of like building a chassis or a complete truck. Everything starts going slower because you're starting to do all the meticulous stuff, the switch panels of this, mounting the Lexan, you know, all these smaller parts that take a long time that you don't see your, you know, 12-hour day, you know, producing much. So it gets a little frustrating, but that's why we always have, you know, the signs. You'll see, like, around the shop, there's cardboards, you know, taped to the walls all over kind of places, and it's, you know, the remainder list or the to-do list. That way you spend less time looking back and trying to think, okay, I need to do this, oh, I don't want to do that, oh, I want to do, no, I don't want to do that yet. And then you go through this whole thought in your head dozens of times in a day till you get to something that you want to do. Because sometimes you're just not motivated to tackle a big job, and you want to just start out small until you get, you know, your motivation built up. But, you know, if you're spending all your time trying to figure out what you want to do, you're wasting time. So that's why you'll see, once we get to a point where all the big stuff is done, we take cardboard to all the trucks and we start writing down on a list what's left to do. That way all you have to do is just look at the list and say, no, yeah, I'll do that one. And then you go straight into tackling that one, you mark it off, and then you look at the list, that's the next one I'm gonna do next. It just makes it to where it's, you know, accomplishes your time better. Probably that's the one thing I tell the guys and, you know, everybody else is, you know, we try to, everything we do, we see if we can beat our times. You know, whether it's, you know, we're building chassis now, a complete truck in 9 days. You know, I think that's pretty good considering the first truck that we ever built was California Kid, when it was back at the Deal Breaker car, and it took me 7 weeks. You know, so from going from 7 weeks down to just over a week to build an entire truck is quite the accomplishment. But everything has changed on how I notch tubings, you know, the frame tables, how I measure, how I cut. The plasma table has, you know, cut weeks out of a truck build just because I don't have to cut all the brackets out by hand and grinding them, because I was very meticulous on, I don't like any of my edges and my corners not to be radiused and cleaned up. They have to be the same. It's So by having a CNC plasma table, that helped a lot in that aspect. As you see on this side of the shop, we try to freshen up everything. Look, Rockstar trailer has been, you know, that old wrap was on it for 6-7 years. Went through a hurricane, you know, it was peeling, it was looking tattered. So it was just time. After we, you know, when we partnered up with the Malicious team, we wrapped one of the trailers to be the Malicious Monster Truck Tour trailer. And then it's just time to do the Rockstar. So we went ahead and had a new wrap designed up. We're actually going to do another little giveaway with Facebook. So we're showing, you know, the progress of that on Facebook. But once it gets completed, we're not going to post any pictures of the completed trailer yet. We're going to make it to where the first person who posts a picture of us going down the road or whatever that sees the new design, posts a picture, you know, they can win something. So it's
nice.
You've seen on Facebook that we were making those, you know, the little motor trophies and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Just trying to change things up a little bit. It's, you know, trying to get out of the same old and just, you know, build something a little different, you know, not wanting to give just t-shirts away, this and that. You know, we always want people to be a part of our team, you know, whether it's behind the scenes like you and your son, and how I always give your son, you know, a little bit of crap here and there because I tell him that he's going to be working for me one of these days. And it's just, I like it when people are involved with us. You know, it's, you know, not necessarily, you know, they don't have to be here, you know, in our way, but I like it when we can do a little video or show how we have done things, or whether it's, you know, telling people, you know, what we've done to make things faster, easier, or cheaper on us, you know, because hopefully it drives somebody else, because I had to learn a lot of the hard ways in many things that I did. You know, that's one thing that, you know, I try to tell my own son, don't be afraid of failure. You know, it doesn't matter if it costs you a little bit of money or a lot of bit of money, as long as you're learning something from it. I mean, I still have those days where I'll text my wife and tell her, oh, I just messed up, I just cost us a bunch of money, because I'll be halfway through a project and realize that I'm a half of an inch out, or, you know, it's not going to work, the geometry's wrong, or just when we were doing fiberglass, when I was learning how to do all that fiberglass, I didn't have one of the settings right. So for my first three bodies that I ever made, never dried. You know, we had them sitting out in the sun for a week trying to get them to cure, and they just never, because the catalyst wasn't correct. You know, so it's, but now we're able to build our bodies ourselves, and it's only costing us about $600 to build a body versus buying them for $3,500. So it's, that's all stuff that we save money. By saving that, then it makes it to where we can afford to put new wraps on trailers, you know, or we can build a new chassis for a truck, or do a body swap, or an engine. It's kind of, that's the SUR way, is try to do it ourselves. You know, it's, I'd love to get to the point where we are 100%, you know, self-contained in building everything. I think the only thing that we don't build ourselves right now is the transfer cases and the actual shop caps. Everything else we're doing ourselves, from the rims now to all our motors, the bodies, the chassis, transmissions. So it's kind of what we do. As you see, there was another trailer that we pulled in, the white trailer. We went and stole that actually from the Groff brothers, because they found out it was going to be too short for them. So we went and stole it from them, doing some trade work, because they've had some rough years, or a rough time this year with blown motors and champagnes and housings and this and that. So we built them a couple of motors, and we're just kind of working off the trailer. But that trailer is going to be the new, you know, SUR trailer, where we'll have it wrapped, where it's just got, you know, 6 or 7 different trucks on the side of it, just to, you know, show the SUR team. It'll just be the SUR trailer. But we're going to haul this other ride truck in it, and then we're going to just start bringing our tank to the shows, just because the tank's, again, you know, just been sitting, hasn't been doing anything. So we're just going to start bringing it to all the shows, just to be a little added bonus, you know, where we'll just make, you know, 1 or 2 passes with it, just to kind of play around, and just something else that we're going to be able to bring to the table that nobody else does.
What's going to be the name of the tank?
We're going to keep it Major Paint.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
We're going to do the body swap. We're going to do the California Kid body on the tank now. So it'll be Major Paint, just because that was kind of like the calling. When I walked around the corner and when we found that thing, I seen that it said Major Paint on the side. It was like, you know, it was the sign from God that said, you need to buy it. And that was literally how I was able to talk my wife into letting me buy it, you know, on the spot.
Yeah.
You know, it was just like, but it's got my name already on it. You know, it has to. So we're going to keep the name. But and then California Kid, obviously the truck is being changed too. So it's, you know, it's hard to be able to change, you know, some of the trucks that we've had for so long, but we know we have to be able to keep everything fresh. You know, it's You know, we want to be able to bring the same quality show all the time, but we don't want to bring the same show. That's why, you know, by doing like the little mascot minion racing and with the pit bikes or the tanks or the ride trucks, changing them up, and then now the kid, we're going to go to a 1941 Willie Scoop body on it, call it Willie Crash. Just something a little different. It'll be that same wheelbase, same, you know, short, but just changing the look up again, you know, and then their same kind of body structure, so I should be able to just to make the rear halo on the kid a removable bolt-on halo, like Identity Theft has. That way we can switch back and forth. If we have shows where the California kid, like Medicine Hat, for some reason I, in Rockstar, can't win in Medicine Hat, but California Kid sweeps the weekend. So when we go back to Medicine Hat, we'll throw the California Kid back on it, just to make sure California Kid is back in Medicine Hat. But so we'll see where the body's being made at GTS still right now. We hope to have it back by April, because we're going to debut the Willie Crash April 28th in Saskatoon. But got any other ideas on what I can do to change things up?
Uh-huh.
What else I can add? I'd love to be able to have like some fighting jets, you know, fly over the arenas, but I just can't afford any of that kind of stuff yet.
Right. I seen your schedule for Malicious Monster Truck Tour. I mean, you got a lot of stops on the West Coast there, up and down the West Coast. I mean, what do you feel about that, when a lot of these speedways like to book you?
You know, that's what we offer the speedways, nobody else does. You know, it started out, you know, where the speedways almost didn't even believe it at first, you know, what we had to offer. So slow, and then it spread like wildfire. I mean, literally last year was probably one of our busiest years for speedways, because they all started catching on, like, you know, hey, we can do this, and it doesn't cost us anything. And now they all pretty much figured it out. So we're doing show after show. They're all close. Now we don't have to leave, you know, we don't have to go to Arkansas. We don't have to go to New Jersey anymore, because we've got so many speedways on the West Coast that they want to be a part of having, you know, SUR and the Malicious team being a part of their speedways. So that's what my goal is, to be able to keep offering the service that we offer to them that nobody else can offer. That way we don't have to leave, you know, the state of Washington or Oregon, or even, you know, I think this year our farthest that we're going to travel is Montana, you know, Miles City, Montana. So it's literally, you got a day and a half drive is the furthest we go, which, you know, makes the guys happy, because a lot of them, you know, they either have full-time jobs that they work, or they just want to be able to be home with their families. And I want to say it was like 5 years ago was the roughest year we ever had. We were gone for 5 months. You know, we left the house the first weekend of January, and we did not get back until into May. It was just, we were going from California to Alabama, I mean, New Jersey, back to Texas, and we never made it back to what we call home. It was just rough. We lost two of our great guys, you know, during that, because they just couldn't handle being gone that long. You know, our dogs, you know, were fed up, and our dogs were fighting each other all the time, because they just want to be able to get out and run. You know, they don't want to live in a 20-foot semi, and none of us do. And now by being able to be so much closer to home, you know, our guys are home for 3 or 4 days a week. The trucks are never look better. I think because now we get to be able to come home, we have a dry shop to be able to work in. You know, we're not working out in a fairgrounds parking lot in the dirt, or, you know, trying to get motivated to try to, you know, touch up your frames when you got the wind blowing or it's rainy. This and that. It's just hard to get motivated to clean stuff, let alone if you have a rollover. It's hard to do fiberglass repair work when you're in a fairgrounds parking lot or a speedway, where when we can come home on a Monday, we can take the body off, patch it back together, put it back on by Wednesday, and then things looking good again. So I think it's the best thing for our team, what we're doing. And again, we're happy, my wife's happy, you know, my guys are all happy, and the trucks are standing together. So it gives us time to be able to change things up and create this. I wouldn't be able to build this if I was stuck in Texas this weekend, you know, sitting in a hotel doing nothing. But instead I get to be home creating another unit. So I think by doing this way, you're going to see the SUR team grow, you know, twice as fast that it already has grown, you know, and I think we're one of the fastest growing teams out there.
As far as number of vehicles, or as far as schedule wise?
I don't think we're really going to grow the number of trucks again. You know, I had taken some of the Monster X Tour trucks for a little while and kind of managed those and ran those, and it was just a headache, you know, having 10 trucks out of one shop. It was just trying to find that many guys, let alone trying to keep up on ordered parts for 10 trucks was hard, you know. And then the Monster Extra trucks weren't, you know, good quality trucks, so, you know, they were different parts, they were different, you know, chassis, so nothing fit the same. So it was trying to make sure that I had parts available for those. It was just tough, and I don't think I would want to, you know, have two separate teams, you know. And most, you know, it's, I think the reason why we're so successful is because, you know, we're, you know, our, my word is my word. It's not, you know, I'm making promises and then sending, you know, Joe Blow and four trucks out to do a speedway, to do an event, you know. It's, and then if it doesn't go smooth, or if it's not this or that, you know, I'm not there to say, you know, hey, we need to do this, or the speedway is not happy because, well, you said it was going to be this and we got this. I think by me being a part of it, you know, and my guys are all there and everybody cares, and my wife, whether it's everything down from the haulers showing up, I think it's just the package that we offer is unbeatable. So I don't think we're going to go more in trucks. I think if we do anything, we're going to just start going to where we bring more of the complete package without having to have tough trucks or FMX, you know, or relying on the race cars to show up. That way we can just generate an entire 2-hour show of entertainment and make people laugh and all that, just all out of our trailers, you know. Make the SUR team have the 2-hour show. You know, I'm not like Feld. I can't afford, you know, a half a dozen side-by-sides and a half a dozen quads and any of that stuff. Plus, I think we'd destroy them during the weeks because, you know, again, we're all still a bunch of young kids. Well, at least I try to think I'm still young at heart, but I think we'd be out there racing them during, you know, on Wednesday, and then we'd be breaking side-by-sides and not be able to get them ready for the Friday. So it's, I don't know what our options are, you know, for going filler, but that's why we're going to bring the tank with us, just to play around with the tank some more. And now that the twins, you know, the Groth brothers, they have that tank, so, you know, they're wanting to get excited to get their tank done, as well as Donald. I gave him a tank, so he's been wanting to, you know, start working on that. So we might have three tanks on the West Coast pretty soon, so maybe that might be something that we venture towards, having tanks at a lot of these shows. I don't know, we'll see.
And then I know a few years ago, maybe you started off with one speedway, two speedways, and now you got a bunch of speedways that signed up with you guys. Was it through word of mouth? Was it through them seeing the action on the ground, or then to sign up with you?
I mean, it's the first one started out, we're up in Canada, and then it was a guy named George that was actually one of the fair managers, or the speedway managers. He moved to another speedway, and then he wanted us to come and do the same thing for, you know, his new speedway. So we did, you know, and then when he moved to another one, we went to that one as well. But then those speedways all wanted to keep having it coming. And then just once, now there was three and four, and there was enough to where it was, you know, when the other speedways were talking about schedules or routing this and that, and then they say, oh, you know, we've got monsters that trucks that weekend. It was, well, who do you use for monster trucks? Because, you know, when they speedways before would go through like a promoter, they couldn't, your average speedway could never afford a show because, you know, promoters are, you know, having to fly themselves in and rental cars and their fees and all the stuff. They couldn't afford to do a show. But then, you know, with, you know, SUR, we're able to go in there and, you know, like I said, do it for nothing. So it's just what we do. I think, you know, we get to be able to drive monster trucks every day of our life if we could. You know, we're getting to that point. You know, if I could drive a monster truck every day and not have to leave our driveway, I would. But unfortunately, we got to be able to go to somewhere to be able to run monster trucks. I think I was just telling the wife, that's the next thing I'm going to do, is go to my next neighbor over and ask him if he's ready to sell yet, because we've kind of outgrown our acreage here. We can't afford the guy that, you know, owns to this side of us on the other side of the shop. They actually just bought the house. It's the door company, the ones that just did the doors. They were just here putting a door in my motor room just so I can keep the motor room cleaner. But I don't think I could ever afford them. It's a really nice place, but maybe the one next to us, maybe that'll be the next one. So we'll see.
You said a lot of these speedways, whenever you guys show up there, that's the probably largest crowd a speedway has seen for the whole year.
You know, what's best for the speedways is not only do we bring, you know, a larger crowd than they get for their average races, we bring a different crowd. You know, it's like most speedways, they when they're doing their shows, they advertise 6 and under free because they don't get kids coming to the speedway. You know, most speedway shows are 3-4 hours long, you know, watching the qualifying and the heats and the trophy dashes and this and that, where we offer the 2-hour show and we target, you know, the 4-year-olds and the 3-year-olds. So, I mean, they're noticing that we're bringing in so many more younger kids than that they've ever had at their, like Western Speedway, they carry candy now, you know, just because it's, they got so many kids now, so their concessions, they have candy versus they didn't have it before. And that's one thing, like having Dallas, you know, with us, that's something that he always starts the show out, you know, asking, you know, who here has ever been to the Rochester Speedway before, you know, and who hasn't, who's new to it. That way the Speedway see how many new people they're actually getting to come to their shows, and whether they, you know, some of them have said, wow, we never knew that there was racing. So that's why some of the times when we do a monster truck show with the Speedways, we do monster trucks and race cars. That way the people that have never been to the Speedway come to see the monster trucks, but now they get to see a little bit of the racing and never know, they might come back to see some of the racing. Or if the Speedways have some of the televisions inside their like concession hallways with some of the racings going on there, that way people can see it and see, you know, oh, there's something else to do here at the Speedway, you know, besides the monster trucks. I didn't know we could see Crash the Pass or Hornet races or whether it be Wednesday night drifting. So it brings them a new audience, as well as, you know, their old audience, but it just kind of gives them a little bit of change as well.
Mm-hmm. You have anything more to add, Bill?
Next time I think we should do this when it's a little colder, or, you know.
Warmer?
Warmer. That's what we're talking, you know, by having the trailers in, it's this piece of property that the shop was built on, because we own this piece, you know, out here, the field and the parking lot, but then I bought out the neighbor, but her property was only 66 feet wide, so the county would only let me build a 56 foot deep shot because you had to have 5 foot buffer on each side. Mm-hmm. So it was like no big deal, you know, but it just stinks because you can't put a trailer in. You know, you could if we didn't have anything else in there, but once we have all our Airboy stuff from, you know, with all the safety clean oil, it's tough because now we have to leave the front of the trailer outside and the doors are in, and we always get that south wind. And that's, these doors face south, so it's just, you always get this breeze that comes in if the doors aren't shut. It's just, like when we did the Mafia trailer, I don't know if you came out for that, I had plywood screwed to the shop and I had blankets under the trailer just trying to keep the warmth in because it was so stinking cold that week. I mean, it was freezing.
Yeah.
At least it's not freezing. The sun came out. I think what we got cold this morning is because Mike Welsh from, you know, Mike Welsh Motorsports came over this morning just to kind of BS. We were standing outside looking at stuff and we got wet. So it's, I think that's where a lot of our cold chills are coming from.
Okay. Thanks, Bill.
Yep.